Mike, Penn State, they're off the bye week. First of all, you just came from the teleconference.
Yes.
Did Franklin reveal anything? I doubt that.
He revealed that his man cave is finished at his house. So
he tried to get you guys off guard by bringing that kind of stuff up. But you didn't go for that, did
crafty.
You?
He's very crafty in that respect.
Okay. Did they fix? We had a week off. Did he tell you this? Have they fixed the offensive line problems and the running game? It was all going to be good this week.
No. Okay. He said there, you obviously, and this is obviously true, you can't wave a magic wand and fix this, but they are working on it, and as they have been working on it since spring ball, and again, he said we are committed to the running game. We think our defense has been good enough in keeping us in games that we can't just go crazy and forget about running the ball. And you know, sometimes that 3-yard run, which some people think is ugly, he thinks is beautiful. And I agree, you know, I agree with that. I mean, you have to mix in the running game a little bit and you have to keep trying to get better. So we'll see how that goes this week.
We were upstairs earlier, and our photographer, who's been to at least, I think, 4 games this year. Have you been to – how many have you been to?
I think I've been to 5.
Okay,
yeah.
All right.
Yeah, I think they've played 5. I've been to 5.
You've been to 5. You're giving me – he said he thinks Penn State's gotten worse as the season's going. They've regressed. Do you think that's the case? And can this bye week sort of heal the injuries slash maybe some mental scars that Hackenberg even has because his offensive line is not very good, so he's throwing the ball and rushing around.
I don't think they regressed week to week. I think they played a really bad game at Northwestern. I'm not sure that's regression. I think that's maybe. That game came at a place where Northwestern was ready to play a good game, and they did. And Penn State has a lot of issues. Penn State has a lot of problems that they were able to take advantage of. So it doesn't feel like regression.
Okay. And Northwestern might be better than we thought because they just won again last week. I think it was Wisconsin. So they're playing
either that or the Big Ten is worse than we thought.
It could be.
Northwestern is kind of the measuring stick for that if you look at their season so far. Anyway.
And I bring this all up because where does Michigan fall into this? They just lost to Rutgers at home. Rutgers was in New Jersey. Rutgers got their big win finally.
Yeah.
But Michigan team is reeling. Everybody wants Brady Hoke out. Okay. Is Penn State catching him at a good time or a bad time?
Yeah, that's a really good question. And I think it's the defining question of Saturday's game. I mean, at some point you think Michigan is going to make a stand. Mm-hmm. And after they played pretty well at Rutgers and they sort of feel like they got a raw deal from the refs near the end of that game on a certain play, maybe coming back home they do make a stand and a lot of it is, I mean, they're a reeling program and it's kind of a volatile thing. Nobody knows, and obviously the coach is going to be gone next year no matter what, so they're not like fighting for his job. This is a tough pick.
Chris Otto, the sports editor, just said to you upstairs when we were talking, will Penn State be able to capitalize on Michigan's weaknesses
State statistically has one of the best run defenses in the country, and Michigan's best running back is hurt. He's broken clavicle. But their best runner is probably their quarterback, so I think even more so than normally he will be a threat with the run. Are they going to be able to throw the ball down the field against Penn State? They're kind of a West Coast team. I mean, their quarterback has good completion percentage, but not really beating you down the field. They have a really good receiver. Funchess is a really good receiver, but I don't think it's a great match. I don't think it's a particularly good fit of strengths and weaknesses, but I don't think it's a terrible one.
We're doing this on a Tuesday, so you still have time to change your mind, but who are you picking?
I probably will change my mind, but at this moment, I'm going to pick Michigan. They're
big
at
house,
home. It's
game,
a tough call. And I have not made a final decision on that prediction, which will come in Saturday, Friday's paper, I guess. But right now, Michigan.